join.
Well, meanwhile, there's more big breaking news which is coming in. This is because we are shifting focus, and this is a development coming in the Sunanda Pushkar death case. In fact, the court has committed the case of abetment to suicide against Shashi Tharoor to the Sessions Court. Well, that's the big breaking news that we are getting for you. Big development which is coming in. Remember, none other than Congress MP Shashi Tharoor has been charged with abetment to suicide after Sunanda Pushkar was found in a hotel room and she was discovered to have died. In fact, this is the big development that we are getting for you. More details are going to be coming your way. In fact, we are picking up from the courts that the Sunanda Pushkar death case, in this case, the court has commits the case of abetment to suicide against Shashi Tharoor to Sessions Court. What really does this mean and the implications of this for the Congress as well as the Congress's MP Shashi Tharoor? It's going to be massive. We'll get you more details right after we connect with Sneha. I believe she's joining us. Sneha, if you can explain to us what happened in the court.
The Magistrate Court has now transferred the case of Sunanda Pushkar death case to Sessions Court. Now finally the trial will begin after the charge sheet has been filed. The court took this cognizance, and the next step is usually in such cases is to refer the entire matter to the Sessions Court. At the same time, the court has also dismissed Subramanian Swami's plea to assist the court in the matter. As we know that Subramanian Swami had initially filed a lot of applications and petitions in the court asking for speedy trial of submission of charge sheet and speedy trial in the death of Sunanda Pushkar case. That application has also been dismissed.
Oh, that's very interesting. BJP MP as well as a lawyer himself, Subramanian Swami, said that he wanted to assist in the case. However, earlier too, he was told that he has no locus standi hence, but perhaps today it has been dismissed. But what next do we expect, Sneha? If the Sessions Court has been asked to now hear the case, does that mean the trial will begin soon? Because this is, after all, a very politically sensitive case.
That is right. Now, when the case has been transferred or committed to the Sessions Court, the trial will begin and the next date of hearing is February 21st.
February 21st, that's the big breaking news that we are getting for you. February 21st is when the Sessions Court is going to begin its trial against Shashi Tharoor for abetment of suicide case. And this, remember, has been rather damning because the court had the option to say that Shashi Tharoor need not be involved and his name could have been scrapped. However, that was not happened earlier. So essentially, the trial is going to now commence and it is going to begin on the 21st of February. As the Sessions Court is going to now begin hearing this case. Well, this has been a very sensational case, and if you can just take us through, Sneha, the merits of the case as has been built by the CBI. Sneha. Well, we'll try and reconnect with Sneha. She has been getting us all the details about the Sunanda Pushkar death case. And of course, a big development on that front is that the Sessions Court has been asked to now hear the case, and now we expect the trial to begin. The next step is going to be that of a trial, and the trial will be against Shashi Tharoor because he has been named in the charge sheet for abetment to suicide. On 21st of February is when we expect this trial to begin. Bhavtosh, if I can come to you, get us the merits of the case. 21st, do we expect the trial to begin?
In fact, on 21st, the Sessions Court will look into this matter, and it could be possible that Shashi Tharoor might again be summoned. The ACMM court had in fact taken cognizance of the charge sheet, went through the charge sheet, whether there was some kind of typo error or any documents that have not been supplied to defense. Now, it took nearly four to five months for the court to do that, and then the court has said that because it's a case of abetment to suicide, and which entails a punishment of maximum of 10 years, the right court where this trial can take place is Sessions Court. On 21st of January, February, in fact, the Sessions Court will hear this matter. Shashi Tharoor is the only accused in this case, in the charge sheet that has been filed with the SIT. He's been blamed for Sunanda's suicide. The SIT had ruled out murder, and they said that it's a case of suicide, where because of continuous mental torture and trauma of Shashi Tharoor, Sunanda committed suicide. The entire case is based on forensic evidence and technical reports that have been in fact been verified.
Bhaktosh, can you explain to us, because this is a big charge and that too against a Congress MP, as you rightly pointed out, if he's found guilty he faces up to 10 years of imprisonment. So if you can just take us through step by step as to what is the body of evidence that the SIT says and alleges that they have collected against Shashi Tharoor.
I mean, that's one of those charge sheets that have never been made public. Delhi police had in fact requested the court that this charge sheet in under no circumstances should be leaked. But what sources in SIT have told us is that the case is based on various technical reports that...
Sorry, in fact,
since the charge sheet was filed and there was the inquiry for the submission of documents, for the supply of documents which was going on in the court has been concluded today. All requisite documents have been supplied. Although there is some discrepancy which we'll point out to the Court of Sessions, but that exercise is over, so case has been committed to Court of Sessions. 306 is punishable by Court of Sessions, so trial will be conducted by the Sessions Court. So it has been committed today and the next date is for 21st of February.
What court said about the Subramaniam Swami?
Dr. Subramaniam Swami, who had filed the application right in the beginning, saying that he has a right to assist the prosecution. He has a right to prosecute on his own. He said, I have a right to prosecute on his own. That was argued at length a few dates back. The order was reserved and the order has been passed today and his application has been dismissed. We had argued that Dr. Subramaniam Swami has no locus in this case because he's a stranger to the proceedings. In a criminal trial, it's a state case. It's only a state which has the power to conduct the investigation and the trial also. So that application has been dismissed and a detailed order has been passed. I have not seen the order as such, so the moment we'll get it, we'll share with you.
So what the court has said about the vigilance report?
Dr. Swami had filed an application that there is a vigilance inquiry which has been conducted by the police and the court has dismissed that application also, that the court doesn't have a right to call for it because Dr. Swami doesn't have jurisdiction to be in the court, doesn't have the locus standi. But the court has directed the Commissioner of Police to preserve that report. In case during the course of trial the session court feels appropriate to call for it, then at least that is available. So that protection has been given that the document should be preserved.
Thank you, sir.
Well, there you just heard from the lawyer of Shashi Tharoor. Just a quick reminder, Sunanda Pushkar, remember, she was found dead in a suite of a luxury hotel.